What's good, TTC? You know who it is. The One Chosen, Ben Squad, Enforcer here. I got something for Panther Nation. I've been the biggest proponent for Cam being trash. This year, going 15-1. I mean, not even the Panther fan saw that. I mean, one of my most watched trash talking videos. The something of Fig Newton. I had over 1,000 views on that. One of my most watched trash talking videos. And you know, when Benjamin went down, you know, I was ripping them a new one. Like, they had no fucking chance. They had no fucking chance this season. But they went 15-1. So I really congratulate the Panthers. Especially Cam Newton. Cam Newton got better this year. But he resorted back to his old ways when teams actually got pressure on him, which was only two teams. And I mean, I could rub this shit in. I mean, I am Panthers fans, but it's not going to be like everybody else. Shout out to P Nasty. I got this jersey right here. It's the custom authentic jersey. You know, it costs P Nasty $300 or so. $325 for shipping. I also think calculate that. You know, me and him made a bet that, you know, when I was trolling the Panther Nation the offseason, I was trolling him so bad, I was all in his heads. That P Nasty accepted my bet for who would have more passing yards, Cam Newton or Ryan Tannehill. And I knew, and I didn't expect him to take this bet, because I would think that everybody knows that Tannehill throws the ball 150 times more than Cam Newton. And I also thought, you know, they would think that, you know, the Panthers are a run first team. Like, Cam benefits from a dominant run game, so he's not going to be throwing that much because he's going to be running. As the season went on, when the Dolphins played the Ravens, Tannehill had, he finished that game. We beat the Ravens, but Tannehill only had like 86 passing yards. So it was close. It was getting hairy down the stretch. And that week we played the Ravens, I think they just played, the Panthers just played the Giants and came through for like 350. So, I mean, I guess, P Nasty, this question for you, if you knew that you losing this bet, losing basically $325, getting a Dolphin jersey, you know, and knowing that you would go to the Super Bowl, would you take that bet again? Will the TTC, anybody would take that bet? No, you just have to pay $325, but your team's going to the Super Bowl. But I guess you need to rephrase that, because you have to say, would you bet $325 knowing that you're going to the Super Bowl and lose? Now, is it worth it then? I mean, I love the crocodile tears. I love the crocodile tears from Panther Nation. But we all knew that the NFL is not gonna let a black man in Black History Month wearing black jerseys and whose team is the Panthers, which basically is, you know, the Black Panthers. You really think they was gonna let them win the Super Bowl? I mean, this game, the media turned this game into black and white. And it's ironic that the Broncos, leading into Thursday, asked the NFL to change their colors to white. And essentially on the field was the black jerseys of the Panthers versus the white jerseys of the Broncos. White versus black. That's what it was all week was leading up to this. It was white versus black. And of course we're going to let the face of the NFL go out on top. We knew this was coming. Panthers fans, y'all should know, I won $600 knowing that this shit was coming. What? A black quarterback in Black History Month wearing black jerseys and it's a Black Panther? We all knew that shit wasn't motherfucking going down. And then Cam in his press conference, I hear Panthers fans saying, oh, if any quarterback that lost would act the same way or would act, I'm sorry, but no. You are contractually responsible for having interviews after the game. It is in your contract. And Cam, knowing that you know, he turned this thing into a black versus white. When somebody asked him early in the week, you know, why is everybody against me? Because we all know, because we black or whatever like that. I mean, he knew this was going to be that type of dynamic to this game. And for him to act the way he acted at the, you know, being asked questions after the game was just something that didn't need to happen. You are not only representing the state of Carolina and the Panthers franchise, but being a black quarterback, you are representing every black person. You are representing every black person, Cam, and you have to act professionally. You have to act professionally. I mean, it's just ridiculous with how you acted. I mean, you just squandered a great season and have to end it on that note. I mean, you could dish it, but you can't take it, huh, Cam? You could dish it, but you can't take it. Now, instead of being remembered for the wonderful season you had going 15-1, most likely people are going to harp on the last thing that they saw from you. And that was you storming out of the press conference, acting like an immature teenage black male. It's time to grow up, Cam. It's time to know that you're not only representing the Panthers brass and the organization and the fans and the Panthers colors, that you're also repping a whole race. I mean, that's about it. And that's basically it. I mean, I could continue to go on these Panthers. I mean, I could say we could get to the bashing part, to the roasting part about how, you know, y'all lost to one of the, what? I think they said Peyton Manning is the oldest winning quarterback. The oldest winning quarterback. You lost to a 39-year-old. How do you feel? You dabbing. The Panthers want to dab. You got fucking Peyton doing the funky chicken. You let an offense that only had under 200 total yards of offense. That's never happened. That's a first. To lose in the Super Bowl, you put under 200 yards of offense. I know that must feel embarrassing. I know that must hurt. That this 15-1 season, like people, I mean, teams that go 15-1 don't usually win the Super Bowl. Regular season MVPs usually don't win the Super Bowl. I mean, the writing was on the wall. The writing was on the wall that y'all was catching this L. And now what? Y'all gonna hang on to this 15-1 Super Bowl appearance for the next 6 months? Which y'all gonna try to do. But nobody remembers the Super Bowl loser. Nobody remembers the team that finished second place. And I don't even want to hear these Panthers fans talking about how they're going to come back. How they may come back to the Super Bowl. What's the percentage of teams that lost in the Super Bowl to even make it to the playoffs the next season, let alone the Super Bowl again? Don't bring up the Seahawks because, you know, that's a definition of a team that's trying to build a dynasty. They went to it back-to-back years. And then the Patriots. If I'm not mistaken, then the Patriots made it back-to-back. But they had to cheat to do that. They had to cheat to do that. I guess what? I guess the other team before that, maybe the Rams went back-to-back. I'm off the top of my head. So not that many teams make it. Especially teams that lose back to the Super Bowl or let alone the playoffs. So y'all might as well you might as well cut that shit down now. You might as well cut that shit down now, Panther fans. Talking about got a bright future, because don't it seem as though teams that make it to the Super Bowl, all of a sudden that next season they're injury prone? Like that next season they get a bunch of injuries because they've played so many games the season prior and at a high level, of course, because they made it to the Super Bowl, that those injuries start to creep up, Panther fans. So, I mean, hey. I mean, I guess you can say enjoy this season. I don't know. You're going to be forgotten about in a month. They're going to only remember and talk about Peyton and the Broncos. Y'all going to be forgotten. But I give y'all kudos for the season. And I want to thank P Nasty for honoring our bet and being a man of his word, much respect, and getting me my Jarvis Landry throwback jersey we won Monday night against the Giants. It's throwback. It's authentic. Don't get it twisted. It's authentic. 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 All motherfucking authentic. 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 I'm not on my motherfucking, sorry Dre, I'm not on that Philly boy from Texas shit. Authentic Nike jersey. But I guess that's all I have to say. The season is finally actually over, football in general. The season is over. I can't wait to look out for these combines, draft, free agency. So, TTC, Trash Talking Circle, you know who it is. D1 Chosen, Fin Squad, Enforcer here. Just got my Landry right here. Man. Oh, shit clean. That shit clean. I'm out.